Outcry tonight after 12 News reveals a slain Wauwatosa officer will not be honored on a national memorial.
It's discouraging and disappointing.
The pressure now coming from the state's top law enforcement officer.
Leading the way with important local coverage. WISN 12 News at 5 starts right now.
12 News first reported the decision to pull Officer Jennifer Sebena's name from the National Memorial last night. Tonight, there's growing outrage about that decision.
Colleen Henry joins us from Wauwatosa, where Officer Sebena was killed on duty on Christmas Eve.
You know, Troy, Officer Sebena was walking to her squad car here in the parking lot last Christmas Eve when police say her estranged husband ambushed her. As 12 News first reported last night, the committee that decides who's honored at the National Memorial will exclude her because it considers her death an act of domestic violence, not a death in the line of duty. That decision has sparked some powerful voices. Officers from across the state turned out to honor Jennifer Sebena's sacrifice for her community. Now they're speaking out about her exclusion from the National Law Enforcement Officers Memorial.
To find that she was excluded, not to mention excluded for a reason that is inexcusable and doesn't fall within their own criteria, surprised me greatly.
Wednesday, Wisconsin's Attorney General sent this letter to the head of the National Memorial asking the organization to reconsider its decision, saying it doesn't even conform to its own rules. Its website lists officers excluded from the memorial as those who die due to natural causes, to alcohol or controlled substance abuse, to an officer's intentional misconduct, to suicide, or to officers performing their duties in a grossly negligent manner.
Some law enforcement officers are excluded because they ended up crashing their car or ended up doing something themselves to cause their own death. And they get included because it's in the line of duty.
In fact, Milwaukee County Sheriff's Deputy Sergio Aleman will be honored at the National Memorial. Investigators determined his death was caused by inattentive driving after he crashed into the rear end of a tow truck on I-43.
It's discouraging and disappointing.
Domestic violence advocate Carmen Petrie says the decision sends the wrong message to officers like Jennifer Sebena, who work so hard to stop domestic violence, and to those who are survivors.
I think there's lots of ways that survivors get the message that they don't matter, that somehow it's their fault. I think this is just one more message like that.
Now this afternoon, National Law Enforcement Memorial officials told 12 News they were meeting to discuss the Sebena case as we spoke this afternoon. Yesterday, they told us they were going to be meeting tomorrow to reconsider that decision, but 12 News calls for clarification were not returned. In Wauwatosa, Colleen Henry, WISN 12 News.
And within the last half hour, Milwaukee Mayor Tom Barrett released a letter that he is sending to the National Law Enforcement Memorial Fund.
He says, quote, denying her this final honor would minimize the significance of her contributions to our community. Officer Jennifer Sebena will be honored on Wisconsin's Law Enforcement Memorial. A spokesperson for the state organization says board members consider the fact that Sabina's death resulted from domestic violence, but determined she did die in the line of duty. Sebena and Milwaukee County Sheriff's Deputy Sergio Aleman will be in the Milwaukee area fallen officers. They'll be honored on May 10th.